Somebody's gonna kill. Better set the big game left to do the picking. said that somebody's gonna kill you. Ease yourself and somebody's gonna kill you. Ease yourself and somebody's gonna kill you. Blind and foolish. peel off the skin like a symphony gear. If something tells me something that I couldn't hear from you. Who's got the dope? Who's got the potential? Thank you.
songs in 10 days. I don't know about you, but I think we left 100 songs behind about show 4. I don't even know how many songs we have played. It doesn't really matter so long as you don't hear anything you like. Then I guess you must... Sorry, I was speaking. Don't start trying to do a request show now. It's way too late. If you don't hear something that you want to hear now, I guess we don't know it. But, you know, I will say that we've had seen some faces here every night. Who are the people? Yeah. Those are the people. Well, those are the people who will be handing out their names and addresses. We're all going to go around later and borrow money from them. We appreciate you coming every night, those of you who come. Anybody being here one other night or two other nights? Really? So that means the rest of you are here for the first time. Yeah. What kept you? You don't know what you've been missing. We've had all sorts of hijinks here. First night I came out here on my own, and then the second night we had a professor of medieval literature playing the Ellen pipes and a fiddle and an accordion and a musical saw. And a mandolin and a double bass. And we saw the lady in half in the second half of the show, and it was like... We had the great Andy Owens on double bass, night 3. We sang songs from Facing the Crowd with a big chorus. Ron Mathis on the piano and our friend Rebecca Lover. And Steve Naive appeared, direct from Idlewild. We couldn't do it tonight because he's all standing in the aisleway, but he came up the aisleway directly from Idlewild off Air France with his airline bag and his baguette and playing the electric melodica. And then it's been just like on from there, and Pete and Davey arrived. Now Charlie Sexton is here with us. Came up with this crazy scheme to play all these tunes for you in different ways, different nights, take them apart, put them back together, sometimes not put them back together. Songs I haven't sung since I wrote them, songs that you never hear, songs you hear every night done differently. I didn't know whether we needed a theme song for this show. I thought maybe it could be Beyond Belief, or it could be... Would it be Beyond Belief, or would it be a brilliant mistake? Would it be Accidents Will Happen? Yeah. Would it be After the Fall? Yeah. You can go on and on and on. I got a million of them. But we want to thank you very sincerely for coming out tonight. I think we came up with the theme song.
Thank you.
And I think it's this one. Nothing will ever be the same. That the promises made, this hollow, but this district's endless town, marked with shadow. So if you see. Turn on me. Yeah, they seem contented. It's all in my disguise. Why do we know why anything? Two fools who suffer down. Either side. Either side. I can't let go my tears. I can't control my anger. I can't admit my
Oh,
look so pretty in your little swim. You look so pretty. You look so pretty. What kind of fool am I? Steve and another guy we used to know went down to Cornwall to rehearse for a record called Trust, from which that song New West Sleeves comes. And the thing about that scrumpy is that it's tasty on the way down. But the secret of the recipe is that when you brew it, it's a kind of home-brewed kind of thing. It's they put a rat in the vat. When the rat is completely dissolved, it's ready to drink. I think that accounts for some of the effect and maybe some of the words in that song. Anyway, we did a record while we was all locked away. Where have you been all this time, by the way? Was anybody at the, what was it called? The set of Moonstruck in down in the South Seaports. Beautiful place. Music goes straight off the edge of the East River, but other than that, it's great on a moonlit night. But we're going to be coming back here in the summer with some surprises. So look out for that. This is kind of like I won't say it's a farewell performance by any means. So we would never say that, but it's certainly probably over this time of the 10 days I've found some songs. Sorry, I'm speaking again. I know it's terribly rude of me. I'm up here with the fucking microphone you paid to come in. If you want to hurry me along, we can go home now. That's fine, you know. No, okay. So let's get that straight. Don't bother Dad at work. You know. So we made this record, it's called The Boy Named If. I know the fables. Play a bit of rock and roll, people lose all their mind. They should ban that kind of music, I think it's. And we're going to do a song for you now, which just tells the tale of it. It's called, imaginatively titled, The Boy Named If. I'm the one you want to be with. If I travel from a town Emergency in the audience. We'll be directly back. apologies to those people I was shouting out there. I didn't realize that we had. Hey, Pete, take it easy a second. Thank you for helping those people out there. Woo! This is just another show, you know?
dumb, you don't know what love is.
Jumping from station to station, so to speak, and I've got young boys who do that, and they've taught me a whole new way of listening. But no, that's a good thing. That's a good thing. Because remember when we had 8-track cassettes? I mean, I'm only just a little bit too young to have had my records come out on 78 shellac, you know. The very first time that Pete and I got in a cab in New York to go to the Bottom Line, the cab driver said, "You want to hear some music? You want to know what the Beatles said when they landed at Idlewild?" And this guy had a sign taped inside the window of his cab that said, "Beatle music played on request." He said, "We'd like to hear I'm Down." Oh, wow. He flipped in an 8-track cassette and on it came. And it was, seemed like anything they want, you want, they got it right here in the USA. So I've always been fond. I discovered a lot of groups as we were traveling around those early kind of tours, because groups that were heard in Akron could not be heard in Texas, and groups in Arizona could not be heard in Boston, so there was always a local shop to go to. And I still keep up that kind of habit to this day. I was in my favorite record shop in the world, which is called Defend Vinyl in Smithtown Road, Liverpool. And I picked up this stack of singles, and there at the bottom of it was this one. And it had made its all its way from Fort Worth, Texas. It was on the Fortet label out of Fort Worth, Texas. And it was a double-sided A-side. Or maybe it was a double-sided B-side. I don't know. It's hard to tell. One side was what I suspect came from the 60s, and it was covered in dust. And one side of the record was I think it might have been a political song, or it might have been terribly rude. It was called "I Don't Want Your Lyndon Johnson." I don't know what it's about, but on the other side was a ballad, and we learned it, and we're going to play it for you now. I see a star up now, cause it's no use when you're falling into the juice, cause it seems to slip down so fine. Take your hand off that glass is mine. It's as bourbon as a smooth silk. Tastes just like cookies and milk.
Thank you.
was beautiful singing. It was like just like a choir of angels out there. You'd never even heard the song until just now. So, you know, this here record, The Boy Named If, I said it was a cult. Yeah. The boys go wild. It's a collection of fables, you know, trace what it's like when you're coming out of childhood and you just want to be with your folks, and then you get to teenage years and you brush your hair down over your eyes and you don't know which way is up and back to front, and does she love me, does he love me, who am I, when will this end, all those thoughts. I remember them well. I'm blessed with a curse of a memory. You know, I've told this story many times, but for those of you who don't know, I was brought up Catholic, which is not something that everybody likes to admit these days for all these reasons. When I was a little boy, I had a sense of my immortal soul, and also the weird thing that I was told I had a guardian angel watching me all the time. I had this big creepy dude in a white robe, invisible, looking at everything I did. And then I had to get the sin off my soul. So I was made to say my first confession before I could take my first Holy Communion. And the problem with that is that you have no concept of sin when you're a little kid. You just do bad things and you get told off. So the nuns gave us a helpful list of commandments of things we might have done. And I looked down 1 to 10 and I went, this, I've never done any of these things. I've never taken the Lord's name in vain. I fucking haven't. I've never killed anybody. I've never stolen. I'm very good to my mother and father. And I don't know anybody that has an oxen that I can covet. So I approached the confessional with some trepidation. There was a smell of incense and Irish whiskey. And the priest was drinking too. I got in there and I thought, well, they'd tumble me if I don't say something. So I confessed to adultery. I didn't know what it meant, but it sounded like fun. And then I came to New York City and I found out that, we'll gloss over that. Now, you get all the way through your childhood with all these torments in you, and then into my life, one summer, a teacher came who was, I have to say, about the worst English teacher I ever had. What she was good at doing was sitting on the desk in a short skirt, flinging her hair around, talking about her life. She was a young woman who was probably only maybe 7 years older than we were, but she left a jar, not a tip jar, the door was ajar, and through that door, although she never taught us anything of value, we saw the world that she came from. A world in which you might kiss the wrong person, you might drink the wrong drink, you might even take funny pills and see monsters. And it would be okay if you were just kind. And so I wrote this here song, kind of like an imaginary version of her. I'm sure she would be terribly embarrassed now if she knew. We never thought any wicked thoughts about her, wicked lustful thoughts. We just kind of were besotted with the idea that she came from a world that at 13 you couldn't join. And I wrote this here song about her.
Penelope, hated me. Sat on a desk and stretched her grip. She cracked her spine and so she said, why you sit on there and make it a blue? Spotlight, vision, jail, pocket time. Two blessings to the eye.
shielded hobby, you're a silly loosening, a style of drum in the shape of fist. You're something through the dot out of this hopeless. Why then you will lose it all.
Cheers.
holy. This is holy. This is holy. The beginning's here. See your eyes. Thank you. men see things differently. This cliff drives away, sharp and falls into the sea. No work today, no hope tomorrow. No bread for breaking, no wine to sorrow. No body selling, no truth to telling. No work tomorrow, no work. Child pride and her ideal bouquet. Boys pick up a rifle, that's too much to say. Count out her teardrops. Wipe them away. Two, we'll be right back. another round of loops. Oh, he is so cute.
detectors. Oh, when they shoot, and lead them up into the teardrop star. But it can't be one where it's got no
songs per night that would give you some kind of idea where we were headed each evening. And we pretty much stuck with that plan until I think we've only played one song every night. So if you didn't hear Allison on the first night, there's no telling whether it'll turn up tonight. Half of the fun of this is being able to bring some songs out of the shadows. And as you know, those of you who are here to hear My Man of Solid the other night sing with Michael Leonard and the horn section. And Jay Swiss the night before, we had people coming up here and bringing something that I couldn't bring to you. I couldn't sing nothing in Spanish like that. Did you see Marisol the other night? Oh my goodness. Yeah, we love her too. Yeah, she's really the most wonderful thing. Check their new record, Lysandra Cecilia's new record out. It's really something else. But we got to the closing stretch of the show, night nine, and I realized that we had rambled far from, drifted too far from shore. I started, we know this because I was on piano. One evening, we had one evening with the night, I think it was the night you turned up, wasn't it? We had a game of musical chairs with me and Steve, right? I tricked him onto the organ that was behind the grand piano, which as you see is not with us tonight. It had another engagement with Billy Joel. I tricked Steve into playing the organ, and then I jumped on the piano, then he jumped on the piano, then I jumped on the organ, and we heard Steve sing Peace, Love, and Understanding. It was a thing of incredible beauty. No, really, because Steve is a natural baritone, so he's singing like three keys higher than he would ever sing in his own shows. We got to the closing stretch the other night at night nine, and I came off and I said, I'm sure there's a couple of songs we should have played, but it was getting late in the evening, and we wanted to take it home with some rock and roll. So we left out a couple of tunes, but if anybody was here the other night, we're going to play one of them for you. Please work on a whole new arrangement. Come on, Steve.
I saw a girl who found her consolation. She said, one day my Prince of Peace will come above her head. The portrait of her father, who will did favor that he gave. I'll never
Stay alive.
Famous member of the McManus family when I started out to be a folk singer. With my pal Alan up in Liverpool in 1972, I joined a group called Rusty New Year's Day, and he said, called me up a couple of years ago. We went our separate ways in 73. We used to play everywhere there were letters, and quite a few places where there wouldn't letters. And, the Catholic girls' school particularly comes to mind. Mary, Help of Christians. Known in Liverpool as Mary Feed the Pigeons. We made our way all the way down the East Lancs Road to Manchester, and they sent us back. Went to London, and you know, to see the Queen, and seek our fortune, and that didn't work out. And we'd pretend that, we'd pretend that we'd written songs by Nick Love. And they would say, that's a good song, that Surrender to the Rhythm, or these songs are Don't Lose Your Grip, blah, blah, blah. It's really good, you're doing really well there, son. You want to keep that going, that songwriting. I said, yeah, that's good. Never told anybody that Nick had written that one, you know. We used to do songs by the Byrds and the Band and Crosby, Stills and Nash. We used to do a great version of Wooden Ships. We did, really. Alan used to say to me, if you're going to go into that solo, remember to keep your lucky rabbit's foot in your hat, in your trousers, you know, because, son, you are going to need it. But like I said, I come from a musical family, but my dad sang on the radio, and that was pretty great. You know, when you were a lad, he was on the television, he was on the radio, and I got to see music up close. Little did I know the shark pool that actually was in show business, but I gradually came to grips with that. And this was because all the way through up until I picked up the guitar, there was not a week that went by without somebody coming up to one of my family and saying, Mrs. McManus, are you any relation to the wrestler? Because at that time, McManuses were not famous for singing. They were famous for flinging big lumps of meat out of the ring. There was a man called Mick McManus. He had black plastered down hair and a kind of compact physique somewhat like mine. He was known as the Dulwich Destroyer, the Lucifer of the jockstrap, the man you love to hate. People would come up to my grandmother and say, "Mrs. McManus, are you any relation to the wrestler?" And she said, "Come here and I'll twist your fucking arm off and then you'll my son sings on the radio. Don't you know?" No, she didn't. She was a very sweet old lady. She didn't do anything like that. I just made that up. So I thought all the way through my childhood, I thought, maybe one day there will come a time when my name is up in lights and I get to I'll write a song about the person I really despise the most, the man you love to hate. I kept that phrase in my head, and then I realized it was about me. I went to a theater on Silhouette Street. I had a taste of decay and a sin I defeat. All of the patrons in the pews were people that I killed or used. The actors on the stage were equally skilled. The players took turns and lighted the fuse.
Bitch, and chill with some of
I went to a house on Silhouette Street where I lived once and died once more. I woke a woman I once adored. Her husband came to the door. I masqueraded identity. He said, I'm pleased to meet you, but you don't know me.
Thank you.
style made in Japan.
Woo!
I call it the Godzilla sound. Somewhere in the east side of town, maybe. Everybody was in love with everybody and the wrong person for 5 minutes. And then we were playing that fucking new wave music everywhere. I hated that fucking music with a passion. Gone and you just find some keys to an apartment and you don't even live there. And this fucking song just kept playing over and over on the jukebox. You took me for a stairwell light, mistook me for a friend. Sunset followed me into the night, mistook me for a friend. Yeah, when it goes 100,000 decibels, the crush, you can bet you know.
the grill. Don't act so mysterious. Damn, you're not curious. Stop it at peculiar. Band it up notorious. Thank you.
thank you very much. I want to thank everybody here at the Gramercy Theatre. They've been most kind. I want to give a big cheer to all our crew. But you know, we want to thank each and every one of them. Richard, Colin, Tony, Karen, and Ellen Whitlow, Andy, Wood. Tom Mathis and all of the singers are facing the crowd. Share the most nights with.
year's last year's mom. All the best wishes and strike hells. I want to go to Chelsea. Oh no, that's our movement. Even though I see the movie, I don't want to check your pulse. I don't want nobody else. I don't want to go to. We'll be right back.
us on the stairs. That's not all what it's cracked up to be. I'm coming one night, falling on your face, and it starts from a
cry.
salutation and shawl. In the after dinner overtures, nothing but an effing thought. Somebody's creeping in the kitchen. There's a reputation to be made. Those nerves are always on a knife's edge. Who's ever played violence on the blade? Love is on the star, Marina, California. Drink yourself in sense of me. Tell you how old he is. He's 39. And Charlie, he wasn't even born when we started. We've been hearing about Charlie since we were. But we just got one more thing to say to you now. Farewell, old Tim.
Energy, my body's
start and we don't have to stop. You know, when we first came to the United States, we only had one ballad. We only had 22 minutes worth of music. And on a good night, we could get that down to 16 and a half minutes. Play this here song every night because it made it too easy for people to like us, and that wasn't the idea. It wasn't. But really it was because I couldn't play the introduction that John McPhee played on the record. But we got Charlie here now to do it to you. We're going to break our own rule now and play a song twice. Not twice tonight, like twice in the whole run. 2, 3, 4.
Thank you. Yeah. of enchanted. As I sit, is a hope lost? Is it only pain and hatred? Is it free? And time I feel like the sunshine. What if I want to know? What's so tired of me slow and understand? I want you.
up and one of us was crying. Want you, you say, young man, I do believe you're dying. I want you, if you need a second opinion, as you seem to do these days. I want you, you can look in my eyes, and you can keep away. Tell me, but seem to forget. I want you, since when were you so generous and articulate? I want you. It's the stupid details that my heart is breaking for. It's the way your shoulders shake. And what they're shaking for, I want you. It's the wind that he knows you now. After all the guessing, it's the thought of him undressing you.
I want you. I want you so bad, it's driving me mad. It's driving me mad. I want you. Did you call his name out? Did you call his name out?
Thank you. I am still in.
Yeah.